Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. If you've ever been caught off guard by a conversation at work that you were completely unprepared for, then you've experienced what I like to call a drive-by conversation. You see, to me, a drive-by conversation at work usually occurs when someone quickly introduces a topic of conversation, giving their point of view, and then ends it without giving you an opportunity to give input or feedback or even think things through thoroughly. Because these conversations begin and end without giving us an opportunity to respond, they can produce mixed emotions that may leave us feeling inadequate or confused. Well, if this has happened to you and you want to know a few specific phrases that you can use to take charge of the situation and stay in the conversation when you're faced with the unexpected, then keep watching. I'm Jaboria and welcome to the number one place for new and emerging leaders who want help with challenging conversations in the workplace. In my previous video, I explained that drive-by conversations are those irritable workplace conversations that catch you off guard. In that video, I outlined the most important things to keep in mind when you get caught in a drive-by conversation at work. So if you're interested in those tips and tricks, take a look at that video after you've had an opportunity to watch this one. In today's video, I'll give you a few suggestions of key phrases that you can use to take control of the situation so that you can respond in a way that leaves you feeling more empowered. So let's set the scene. Imagine being at work and all of a sudden, your colleague suddenly approaches you to talk about a project or a work task that wasn't mentioned to you before and that you weren't prepared to discuss. These drive-by conversations always have the worst timing because they usually begin when you're totally focused on something else and you're totally not prepared to discuss that topic. So the conversation starts before you know it and the whole thing is over and then poof, your colleague is gone. The thing that you want to do in those situations is be ready with a few short replies. And because you're watching this video, you'll be more than prepared to do so. The first thing to ask yourself is, what kind of reply does the situation call for? When you're confronted by your colleague with the unexpected conversation, is your initial gut feeling that you agree with what is being said to you? Or is your initial gut feeling that you kind of disagree with what they're saying or what you're hearing? You'll usually be able to determine this pretty quickly based on how you feel when you're first presented with the information. This will be important for determining how you want to respond in order to craft your quick reply. If your initial feeling is undecided because you need more information or you just need more time to think, don't worry because I have an example for that too. This brings me to the first response type that you can use, the non-committal response. The non-committal response gives you time to think things through when you're trying to decide whether or not you agree with what you're hearing. It allows you to decide if you agree or disagree and follow up later. It's important to remember that you shouldn't feel pressured to give a response that is thoroughly thought through. The nature of the drive-by conversation is that you were completely caught off guard, so if you need time to process your thoughts, weigh the pros and cons, or research the topic, your practiced, quick response should reflect that. This is why the brief, non-committal reply is perfect for this situation. You can use phrases like, "Allow me to think about it and follow up with you." Or you may want to say, "I may need more time to explore this topic." Responding in this way shows that you're agreeable without requiring you to make a firm commitment. Here are two more replies that you can use. "Can we revisit this conversation later so that we can discuss this some more?" Or you can also say, "That's interesting. I haven't thought about that." These two responses will ensure that you have an opportunity to follow up later with your talking points. So go ahead and give this video a thumbs up or a like if you've heard or if you've used phrases like these at work before. Next, I'll suggest a few phrases that you can use if you initially agree with what you've heard, but you have follow-up questions or you need time to look into things. You can say something like, I don't have a lot of time to discuss it right now, but I'm open to learning more about it later. Putting it this way lets you put the discussion off, and at the same time, it shows that you're open and cooperative. You could also say, I'm open to that plan, but I think that we should meet to review it. Or you could say something like, I'm interested in discussing it with you. Let's go ahead and schedule a meeting. This lets your colleague know that you're willing to review the topic in more detail at a later date, and setting a meeting date and time would be the best and most appropriate way to discuss it. Before we move on, let me know in the comments below, what are some of the quick replies that you have tucked away and you use when you're caught off guard at work? Let's move on to the next example. Here are some examples now of what you can say when you disagree with what you've heard. You can say something like, I'm not sure that we should move in that direction, but let's schedule time to discuss it. This response lets your colleague know that you're not on the same page with them. It's a response that gives as little offense as possible while suggesting that your response is still a no. Another possible reply is, I don't think we've had an opportunity to explore all options. Let's do some more research before moving forward. This sort of reply suggests that a more in-depth conversation is needed, and also that this particular topic, you're not thoroughly ready to discuss at the moment. And it's usually because it really can't be fully explored during a 2-minute conversation. Now, the next suggestion involves a more direct reply that will stop the conversation in its tracks. If you say something like, it's not the time to move forward with this project, or we need to table that discussion for the time being, this means no, no, no. I'm not here for it at all. We know that the ultimate goal as a leader is to have good conversations that allow you to continue to have positive interactions with your colleagues. This doesn't mean that things will always turn out perfectly. Remember that these situations are difficult to accomplish without preparation and practice. So if you forget the suggested responses that I mentioned today, don't sweat it. The most important thing is not to put unnecessary pressure on yourself to come up with the right answer on the spot. If all else fails, you can always say, let me get back to you. That's always a perfect response. The good thing is that you can always follow up with the conversation later. You can always send an email or schedule a meeting after you've had time to think. This will give you time to determine the best and most appropriate course of action, and you'll be prepared on what you want to say. Now, if you're watching this video and you're interested in learning about how to respond to emails using the best corporate clapbacks, be sure to subscribe and click the notification bell so that you'll be the first to know when my new video gets published. If you enjoyed this video, also check out my companion video where I discuss the key things to know about drive-by conversations. So as always, have a great week, be kind to yourself, and thank you for watching.